Good morning, friends. Pastor Kelly here for the Wednesday edition of Sound Bites. And I just want to encourage you, and these are 4 minute, quick little mini messages. If this is sort of like sticking out like a sore thumb, go back and listen to the other ones, because these are all progressive. They build on one another. So if you're just joining us like for this morning for the first time, you may miss all the lead up that brought us to this one. Now, we've been talking about garbage and rats. Garbage being the human woundedness that we have in our souls. We all have it. You have it and I have it. Rats being the devil and the demons that love to attach itself to that garbage and attack, hopefully stealthily, hopefully without ever getting acknowledged that they're the ones doing it, and which happens most of the time. We never attribute it to the devil. All the devil's done is exploit the woundedness we already have. In our flesh, in our humanity, the secret sins, the self-consciousness, trauma, rejection, grief, the deep needs, human unmet deep human needs that we all have, stuff that happened in our childhood that our parents may or may not did to us, love and affection, all those things. And again, most of the time we never give the devil credit for this stuff, but that's exactly where he wants to attack us. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers. So the principle here is we clean up the dump and the rats will leave. Trust me, I'm the dump boy. I understand. We clean up the dump and the rats will leave. So we want to deal with spiritual warfare. The first thing we want to deal with, I can look for a demon underneath the pillow and I may or may not find him. But if I really want to deal with spiritual warfare, I really want to deal with inner healing, because when I heal myself internally and I let Jesus Christ invade these areas of garbage in my soul, I'm taking away the territory and the place, as we like to say, that the devil likes to attack. A few verses. 2 Corinthians 2, verse 10. Anyone whom you forgive, I also forgive. Indeed, when I have forgiven, if you have forgiven anything, it has been for your sake in the presence of Christ. Verse 11, here's the verse we know. So that we would not be outwitted by Satan, for we are not ignorant of his designs or his devices. So what's he saying here? This particular case is talking to the church about a man that we see in 1 Corinthians chapter 5, that same man that fell into sexual sin that they broke fellowship with because he did not repent from the sexual sin. Now in 2 Corinthians chapter 2, he's sort of rebuking the church and saying, you need to forgive this man and accept him back into fellowship, because unforgiveness, he says, is a satanic device. Unforgiveness, we've used this before, is giving, how's it go? Drinking poison and expecting somebody else to die. I forget how it goes. That's unforgiveness. And then the devil looks at this is a big area where he loves to attack. Because this will grind us into smithereens when we see people that we consider have hurt us or wounded us, and they seem to be prospering. They don't seem to be paying any price for it. We grind our teeth and wonder why God has not judged them like they should be judged. My friends, listen, do not be ignorant of his devices. Learn the art of forgiveness. This is another message. Maybe we'll attach ourselves to this on Friday. Because if you don't, you have given a place to the devil, and there's no other place he likes to attack than a believer that has unforgiveness in his heart. Jesus, bless these words in Jesus' name. Amen. Bless you all.